UI path also. Okay, so robotic process automation, let's talk about robotic process automation. Robotic process automation stands, it's an acronym actually. It's an acronym of RPA, okay, where R stands for robotic, okay, P stands for process, and A stands for automation. Okay, to define this, to explain this robotic, okay, just let's try to take one simple example. Just imagine, guys, okay, you are performing certain task. You want to execute some task in computer. Understood? And to perform certain task in computer, obviously I have to give the instructions. How generally we give the instruction? From the input devices. Okay, generally what we do, either I'll press the keys, okay, from the keyboard, or else I'll move the cursor, okay, from one place to the another place. Now imagine, okay, suppose if I want to complete any task, okay, there should be, okay, the proper physical involvement of the humans are required, then only you can complete the task. And as we just imagine, guys, okay, since it's very difficult to sit for a long time. Suppose let's say the task is very, okay, very big task you got, understood, so you cannot sit in front of the computer for the long time. Let's say you cannot sit maximum for the 8 hours, understood, so it's kind of, obviously it will take a lot of time, understood, to complete the task what you can do in, let's say, the one day, so maybe you will take around 2 to 3 days. Okay, it's kind of a loss for the industries. So what the industry wanted to do, right? Okay, without the involvement of the human. Okay, without the involvement of the human. Okay, so the automatically the task should get placed. Suppose let's say, imagine I want to create one file. Okay, in Word, let's say the Word, Microsoft Word. Okay, so to create the file in Microsoft Word, I have to press the keys. I have to move the cursor from one place to the other place. Next, I have to press the keys here. Understood? But in robotic process automation, what happened? You need not to press the keys. Automatically, the machine itself will take care of that one. Automatically, it will open the Microsoft Word. It press the contents, understood? And it will save it and it will mail it. Understood? Without the involvement of the human. Understood? Robotic means we are just replacing the human with the robots. When you are, okay, registering with the UiPath is the industry company, okay, who is providing the services in the field of robotic process automation, understood? So when you are registering with the UiPath, okay, they will assign you, they will give you one robot, okay, so you can replace that robot with the physical involvement, okay, physical activities of the humans here, understood? Now next is P, okay, P stands for process. It is nothing but the sequence of the steps. Okay, I hope all the students can see my screen, I guess. Okay, let us imagine that I want to move the cursor. Imagine that right now I am here in this position called RPA. Now I want to move the cursor. To move the cursor, I have to move my mouse. If let us imagine that I want to move the cursor right from here to the, okay, screen, that is the start button. Okay, to move the cursor, I have to move my mouse also. Understood? But in the case of a robotic process automation, what happens, you need not to touch your mouse, okay, so automatically the cursor will be moved from this position to this, and it will press this button, it will open, okay, your start, all the options, and you can select from there, okay, start button, understood? That the moving the cursor right from this position to the task or the start button, this is called one kind of a process, understood? The process, okay, who is doing it? Robot is doing it, okay, so I'm not doing, okay, there will be no physical involvement, okay, robot itself is doing, okay, that whatever the movement you are performing through the RPA, okay, UiPath, that is called the process here, understood? Now next we have the another called the letter called automation. Automation is nothing but without human intervention, so that means I'm not going to touch my the computer. Believe me, guys, it's been almost 10 years in IT sector now. Daily I used to sit around 10 hours per day, okay, I used to spend a lot of time in front of code, latest technologies, etc. Okay, right now even I feel, after some time even you also feel like, okay, not to sit in front of the computer, you want to enjoy, you want to go out, understood, you want to spend some time with your family, okay, so the commitment will be there from the industries, okay, you have to complete your task. So in that cases, what you can do, you just analyze it. What are the daily activities you are doing it? Design the model. Okay. After designing the model, just run in the orchestrator. Turbine. So whenever someone is triggering, let's say some customer is trying to request to the company, your presence is not required. Automatically all the tasks will be taken care by the RPA using UI Upbath. Understood? So that you can enjoy your life, enjoy your time with the family. Okay, that is one more major advantage of learning robotic process automation using UiPath. Now next is robotic process automation. When it comes to robotic process automation techniques, system, there are vendors. Competitors are there in the market. Understood? And these are some of the major vendors of the robotic process automation technology, in which UiPath is one of the leading service provider. Next we have Blue Prism. Next we have Automation Anywhere. Understood? What made me to learn UiPath? That is important. When it comes to UiPath, UiPath contains even the community version also. The models of the UiPath is free of cost. You just download and you can practice the UiPath. Even in the case of Blue Prism, it is not free. It's not an open source. It's not free. Understood? You need to pay for this one. Per year, they are charging around 6 lakh rupees. For two robots. They give two robots, and the charges for those two robots are 6 lakh rupees. Now, next is automation also till 2018. This was commercialized. That means this was not free. Understood? Later on, they analyzed that the market, they are dipping down in the market. So they also came up with the community version. Now, in Automation Anywhere also, the community versions are available. After 2018. Now it's up to you. Either you can switch it to UiPath, or you can execute some of the projects to Automation Anywhere. What I recommend you to choose UiPath, because nearly 45% of the market is taken over by the UiPath. Suppose that say there are 100 vacancies in RPA, Robotic Process Automation. So out of 100, 45 will be from UiPath. Hope you are clear with this. Any questions here, participants? Hello. Any questions? Any questions, participants?
Yes, sir.
Bear with me, just the theory part. Let me try to finish this. Next, directly we'll dive into the hands-on session. So next, Blue Prism. These are the vendors. UiPath. Now next, we'll try to see how to install this UiPath Community Edition. But before that one, I just want to clear two things. One is called activity, another is called the sequence. So because the entire project, if you take any the complete project in UiPath, so the complete project works on only two principles, that is called activity and the sequence. Activity is nothing but any kind of a task, any task, what you are performing in the computer. Suppose let's say I'm moving the cursor right from left to right or right to left. So the moving the cursor from left to right or right to left, it is called activity. Moving the cursor right to left is one activity. Next, moving the cursor right to left is another activity. Got a point? Suppose let's say right now my cursor is here. Understood? I'm moving the cursor right from this place to the star button. That means moving the cursor from this place to the star button is called the activity. Now let us imagine that I have moved the cursor right from this place to here. Then I am clicking the start button. So that meant after clicking the start button, let us say, hold on, I'm clicking the start button. After start button, let us say I'm choosing the camera. So that takes the shape of sequence. Sequence is a collection of what? The activities. So I have moved the cursor right from this place to this. Then I did what? I clicked the button start. Understood? Then after clicking the button start, I have selected the camera. So that means I'm performing three activities sequential. So that means that is a collection. Generally what you can say is it's a sequence of what? The activities. In robotic process automation also we does the same thing. If you are clear with what is sequence and activity, how to perform the activity one by one, next, how to convert that one into the sequence, done. 50% of the you have done the robotic process, the automation. Hope you are clear with this. Okay, if any doubt, please let me know, or else we'll go to the installations the part. So for the installation, okay, what you can do is there are two methods to install the robotic process automation. First one is by clicking on their official address. Go to Google. Okay, so how? In Google, go to Google, hold on. Okay, in Google, just type UiPath. Okay, UiPath, official website. Go to UiPath, official website. So here, so in the first stage, in the first option itself, you will get. So this is their official site, that is called uipath.com. Okay, click on uipath.com. Hit on uipath.com. So you will be hover over to there. The official site here. Okay, so this is the official site of UiPath. Okay, UiPath. So now just try to have the brief review on this website. So recently, 10 days back, they got one big project from the NYSE. Okay, that was one of the greatest, one of the big achievement what they have achieved in that so far. Now, as far as the vendors are concerned, UiPath is already used by, okay, the companies like Google, NASA is also using, Autodesk is using, okay, next to DHL, we have HP, okay, with Virgin we have. So these are some of the few companies, okay, who are using robotic process automations. Now, okay, even if you go to middle scale companies, okay, most of the companies are migrating towards them. The robotic process, the automation. Now, if you want to download, okay, the community version of this robotic process automation, hit on this button. Okay, it's a free version. You need not to pay for this one. And thanks to PA College of Engineering, we have already registered with the UiPath. Okay, and they have given around 350 robots for us. We can use it for our daily activities. Similarly. Even you can have your own robot, okay, and that robot will work for you. Hit on that one. So you will be asked to register with the UiPath. Hold on 4 seconds. So I have already registered. Okay, so if you are not registered, you will get the link here. Okay, so either you can register directly with the Facebook account, LinkedIn account, or through the Gmail account. So already I have registered. Okay, so let me try to register with the same email official account. Since you have the official email address, okay, so you can register directly through official email address. Okay, or else you can use your personal email address also. There is no restriction. Hold on. Hold on, white switch. Network is low. Hold on, please. So once after successful registration, okay, you will get the dashboard like this. I hope all of you can see the dashboard. Any confirmation? Okay. I hope I'll consider that. Okay, all of you can see this dashboard. So here what you have to do is you can see on the right corner there is a button called Download Studio. Can you see the students? Hello. Yes. So on the right corner you can see the button called the Download Studio. Okay, click on that one. So the moment when you click on this, automatically you will they will allow you to download. Since it contains around 450 MB of the file, okay, it will take little time. Already I have downloaded and I have installed it on my system. Just download this one. So after downloading, so you will get the icon. with an extension called .exe, like how you are installing your application programs. Okay, right, just click on that icon, next, done. Okay, so execution, I mean the installation will take place. Similarly here also in UiPath Studio, so you can install just like how we are installing the our application, the program. Understood? So after successful installation of that the UiPath, the studio, okay, you will get two icons. It comes with the two icons. One second. Hold on. You'll get two icons after successful installation of the UiPath. Suppose if you want to access UiPath, okay, just go to your search button, type UiPath. Okay, type UiPath. Now you can see, okay, here you can see here, okay, so you can see two icons. Can you see participants? Hello, please, can someone reply please? Hello,
sir.
Okay, so okay, so you will get two icons here. One is called UiPath Studio and another one is called UiPath Robot. Understood? So as I told you in the beginning, okay, this contains, when it comes to UI RPA using UiPath, okay, this comes with the three different components. The first component is called UiPath Studio. The another one is called UiPath Robot. The third component is called UiPath Orchestrator. Understood? So now how it works? UiPath, suppose say, imagine you want to design some programs. Okay, for some activities, let us imagine that I want to send 500 emails. Okay, 500 emails using UiPath. Okay, in 5 minutes, imagine. Understood? It's as a human. Okay, if I sit the whole day to send the 500 emails, okay, it's not possible for me. Trust me. But using the UiPath, it is possible. In 5 minutes, you can send all the 500 emails. Okay, let us imagine that I want to design such type of a model. Okay, to design that, okay, generally what we do, we try to make use the component called UiPath Studio. Okay, UiPath Studio is a platform where generally we design the programs. Understood? Trust me, here coding is not there. It's all about dragging and dropping. I'll try to avoid the coding as much as possible. I think what I felt, 90% there is no coding in this. Okay, in some areas, when it comes to complex data, there you need to the code. Understood? Now next is we have robot. Robot is nothing but your computer itself. Okay, the computer itself. The moment, let's say you have designed some model and you want to execute it. Okay, who is going to execute? The robot will execute that the model. Understood? So the robot will execute that robot. The other component is called the orchestrator. Suppose let us imagine that I want to display the result in some other computers. Suppose imagine that there are 65 students here. I want to send, okay, the greeting message for all this, the 65 students. Okay, for all the 65 students at one instance of time. It's not possible, okay, when it comes to manual process. But using the automations, robotic automations are concerned, it is possible. So if I want to send the greeting messages to all the 65 students, what I will do? I'll design the model using the studio. Understood? Next, after designing, I will deploy that model using the orchestrator in the cloud. Got a point? Then I will trigger some events. If let us say students is logging, okay, login, okay, he is joining the session, okay, so the moment he joins the session, I'll send the greeting message. Welcome to RPA using UiPath. Understood? So that kind of an automation we can achieve. But to do that one, we need an orchestrator. Definitely we'll try to execute some projects related to by using the orchestrator, some project using studio and some projects by using robots. Now next, maybe you guys are a bit confused about the studio and robot. Okay, so studio and robot reside in the same machine, remember. Understood? Studio generally we use to design the program, as I said. Now robot, why robot comes? Execution is taken care by the robots. Now let us imagine that I want to do certain kind of a marketing in the US location. Okay, US location. Say I want to send some messages, email about my services, late night 2 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 2:30 p.m. I want to send. So it's impossible for me. okay, to get up at 2 o'clock and to send the messages, like 500 emails I want to send. So what I will do, I will design the model and I will configure that model inside the robot. Understood? So after configuring, what I will do, the robot, since it will be continuously, it will be working. Understood? It will be triggered at 2 o'clock and he will send all the emails at 2 o'clock without the involvement of the humans. This is the beauty of RPA using UiPath, guys. And trust me, believe me, data is rapidly generating. We are generating the data rapidly. As per my update, last time, I think my 2 months back, I updated. Okay, right now, the whole world is having 55 zettabyte of a data. Okay, it's very huge data. And as per the predictions, expert predictions, what they said, till 2028, we are going to have 175 zettabyte of a data. Just imagine, guys, okay, how much amount of data we are going to generate. When you have a huge data, understood, manually it is not possible. It is impossible for us to handle such type of a data. Understood? We need certain kind of an automation. Let the machine itself will take care of the data. Understood? And they should take care of the data based upon our requirement. Okay, so obviously what is the handy for us? What type of tools are handy for us? For us, the handy is UiPath. Okay, automation anyway, Blue Prisms. Okay, so these are some of the demand. Now next is regarding about the requirement. Last time I met your seniors also, okay, during that function, okay, I met the seniors. Generally when I met alumni, okay, the seniors, I used to discuss in which technology they are working, okay, so that I can update myself. Understood? So most of the time, okay, I heard in recent years, in coming 2 years, okay, back 2 years, if you go to back 2018 till 2020, okay, most of them said, sir, I'm working on RPA, robotic process automation. Some students are working on Blue Prism, some students are working on automation using UiPath. Okay, some of them are working in the other automation anyway technology. Combined. So the now next the requirements are going to increase this one. Okay, so it's a right time for you to focus on this RPA using UiPath. Okay, so now next is after successful installation of the UiPath, let's try to open this one. If you want to open, as I told you, just type UiPath. Okay, hit on this UiPath Studio. Don't get confused. I'll tell you how to configure robots in machine, local machine, later in coming sessions. Understood? 24/7 it will work for you. Understood? If something is triggered in your system, it will intimate you. Understood? So now next is, let's try to work on UiPath Studio. Hit on UiPath Studio. Hold on, this will take little time. Be patient, guys. Be patient, please. Hold on. If any questions, you can ask participants related to RPA using UiPath. Any questions? Hello. Any questions, participants? Hello. Any questions?
No, sir.
Okay. So select this. Yeah, it started now. Now you can see deploying. I'm deploying this one on my machine. Okay, if the version is 2019, the latest version is 2021.1.4. Version is available. So the moment when you are downloading the latest version, that is 2021.1.4 version. Okay. Next is, hold on. Let this get open first. Hold on. Let me minimize this. Hold on, it takes time. hold on, it's taking time. Started now, you can see the icon. Okay. Hope all of you can see the screen. Hello.
Yes.
All of you can see the screen, right?
Yes.
Okay. So the first is we need to. One second. Started now. First and foremost is we need to create the project. Okay, this is the main dashboard, not main. Okay, the front dashboard of the UiPath dashboard, where you will have 5 options. You can work on the cloud environment also. You can have the team also, like DevApps. Okay, that also it supports for DevApp also. Okay, if you want to configure the robot, you can use settings here. We'll talk about that one later. Okay, now as I told you, there will be the concept of process. Always, if I want to start any project, okay, generally we can start the project with the process. Next, library systems are there. Suppose, let us say, you have designed some model. Okay, so after designing that model, you can take that model as a class. Okay, and after calling the after creating the class, so you can reuse that class in other models. Okay, so to do that one, we generally use library systems. Next, transactional process we have. Okay, agent process improvements, robotic enterprise, the framework. Okay, so this is for the cloud-based system. Generally, we use this. Let's try to finish this 2 part first, then we'll go for these things. Understood? So if I want to create any model, okay, just hit on process. So you will be hover over to the file as usual, like how we are doing in other tools. Okay, so how we follow the procedure, same here also, you try to follow the same procedure. But here one thing what you can observe here is, you while giving the name of the file, okay, so you cannot give the space in between the two words. Suppose, let's say RPA, let's say CS. Okay, CSECEE. I have given CSECEE. So you can see here, there is a red mark here. Okay, a red icon you can see. Okay, that means it is not supporting. This is not the policy. Okay, the format of assigning the name for the class here. Okay, or the file name. Understood? So there should not be any space in between the two files. Always remember this one. Okay, so now next, since the syntax is proper, you'll get the green signal here. One more thing, what I have analyzed, if you take legacy programs, old programs, you take C program, C++ program, even you take Java, okay, even you take Python also, okay. So if there are certain errors, okay, while compiling, okay, it will not allow us to the process that the model for to the next level. Okay, but the major challenge here is, okay, you take C, C++ or Java, we need to compile. Okay, we need to compile, then only we will come to know that there are certain errors. But in the case of robotic process automation, there is no concept of compiling the program. The moment when you type, automatically in the background it will compile the program. Understood? Okay, instantly it will compile. Okay, it will give the result. If it is a red mark, that indicates that there is a something error in the program. Okay, if it is a green mark, the program is correct. Understood? Now next, let's try to create. If you want, you can give the descriptions also. This is the location. Understood? By default, the location will be this. Okay, so now next is create this. So after creating the process, it takes time. Hold on. it's restoring all dependencies which are required, to run ribbons, activity pane, and the property pane. We'll talk about that. Hold on. It's adding the dependencies, okay. Nothing but the classes, the default classes which are required to run any automations. Okay, hope all of you can see the main dashboard now, right? Hope you can see the main dashboard.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Hold on. Okay, so this is the main dashboard of robotic process automation. Studio. Next is here. A few things I want to clear first. This entire dashboard is divided in three parts. Okay, remember, this can be an interview question. The dashboard is divided in three parts. This portion is called ribbon, which comes start, design, and execute. So this portion is called ribbon. Generally, we say in other software tools called main menu or something, we say, but this is ribbon. Further, the ribbon is divided in the four parts. First part is called recording. Have a look on this. This is called recording. This is one of the most powerful tool in UiPath. Suppose, let's say, remote, I want to record the screens of the remote machines. Understood? So that means, let's say, I want to have the image of the remote machines. Okay, so if I want to capture that one, I can do it through record. Suppose, let's say, I have some machines in college. Let us imagine that is on, active mode. And I want to know what is going on that screen. Understood? I can do it through here from my home using the recording system. Understood? Now, let us imagine that I have recorded the screen. So after recording the screen, I can give that one to the AI machine, artificial intelligence machine, so that the image can be analyzed, what is happening in the that particular specific location. Got a point? In the same way, next is a scrapper. So that is called a scrapping tool. Scrapping tool means, imagine you want to purchase a good mobile from Amazon, and your budget is around 5,000 rupees. Understood? So obviously, if you want manually, you want to browse, purchase, you will take obviously 2 to 3 days. So you will check all the configuration, offers, everything you will check. But I can scrap the entire Amazon. Suppose, let's say, I want to purchase the mobile of which fall under the category of 5,000. So I can scrap I can have the list of all the mobiles which is in Amazon which fall under the category of 5, and you can give the configuration also. I want this kind of a configuration. List me out. Give me all the mobiles which fall under this category requirements. We can do it. Understood? Maybe once I tried that one, it gave me around 1,500 mobiles I guess. Understood? And in that also, further we can categorize, subcategorize based upon your requirements. It's so easy, and it takes hardly 10 to 12 seconds, not more than that. Now next is we have data scrapping. This is one more, the very powerful tool. Right now, if you take my case, my hobby is of collecting the data, because I know the power of data in future. Right now, I have around 4 terabytes of data. All the email addresses, you take the names, phone numbers of all the big businessmen throughout the world. And I know how to use that one in future. That is my hobby. How I have done it? Through this technology called data scrapping. Understood? You can scrap the data. You go to all the website, official website of the companies. Understood? Select some of the fields. Understood? Select some of the fields. And scrap the entire data from that company. Got a point? And store it in the CSV file or the Excel file. We can do it. Understood? So these are a very powerful tool, students. In later on sessions, we will see how to use these tools in the future. So now next, this fall under the category of water. The ribbon. Understood? Next, we have event, user events, trigger. Let us imagine that I want to trigger something. if some event is happening, I want to trigger some, okay, the greeting message or something else. So we can do it using the user events here. Now next we have this fall, rest of the things fall under the category of what I can say, ribbon. Publish is one more thing. Regarding about saving and publish, two things I want to clear here. Okay, saving is nothing but you are saving the files within the machine. Okay, local machine. That means the file will remain reside inside your machine. Now next, publishing is nothing but you are deploying the file in the cloud, in the orchestrator. Understood? So that file will remain where? One file or copy of that file will remain in the orchestrator. Okay, the another file will remain in your local machine. You trigger from here, okay, that will get affected in the orchestrator. Understood? These are the two differences between the save and the publish. Understood? Save as templates is also we have. There is a concept called reframework. We will try to discuss about reframework, okay, in UI path. Okay, so it gives the complete template. You just drag and drop all the model. Okay, so the complete system will be ready. Okay, so these are things. Now next we have this, the other component is called activity pan. This is called activity pan. Okay, so this makes our job easy. Okay, you need not to code for this one. Suppose let's say I want to send a greeting message. We have the message box here. Just drag and drop it. We'll do that one. Drag and drop it. Your program will be ready. Okay. So in the same way, we have the options like here, UI automation, graphical user interface, and UX automations. We can do it here. Okay. Next, user events. We have orchestrator. As I told you. Okay, major three component, out of which the one more component is orchestrator. You can find the orchestrator here. Understood? Orchestrator, we can configure the orchestrator under activity pan. Understood? Robots, now you are familiar with two components. One is called UiPath Studio and another is called, okay, the orchestrator. Next, there will be robot. We need to configure the robot. I'll demonstrate that one in coming sessions. Next, the programming part also we have. In case if you want to make programs, do programs, you can do it. You are most welcome. Okay, workflow we have. Okay, so this fall under the category of activity pan. Slowly, I'll demonstrate this. Next, other component is called a property pan. Suppose you have taken my message box. Now you want to configure that one. Okay, so we can configure using the property box here. Left and right, property box. Understood? So these are the major components of the UiPath Studio. Hope you are cleared now. Now next, if I want to start any program in UiPath, okay, so generally we start with the flow, generally data flow. It seriously take care of all the data flow in the UiPath. Understood? Okay, so to do that library systems, we have three options here. One is called sequence. I said about sequence. Okay, sequence and activity. Sequence is a collection of activities. Got a point? So that is one sequence we have. Understood? 9 weeks we have flowchart. Suppose let's say there are certain condition. Okay, number is greater than or lesser than XYZ. Understood? There is a certain kind of end condition. Okay, so in that cases we have to take some looping statement there. In that cases we can go for flowchart. There is no restriction either. You can start the program using flowchart, or you can start the program using the sequence. Right now we will start with the sequence. Okay, so even you can see the sequence here also. Favorite, under favorite you will get the sequence. Okay, either you can start from here, you can start from here. Let me drag and drop. Okay, let's try to have some greeting message now, just like old times how we start the programs. Okay, so sequence, I got the sequence here. Have a look on this. All of you can see here the model is, I have deployed the model sequence. That means library system, I'm starting with the sequence now. Now next is I want to send some greeting message. Okay, to send the greeting message, what I will do, there is a pan called here, message. Hold on, there's a pan called message. I'll drag and drop here. Hope all of you can see here, participants. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I have taken the message box and I'm dragging and dropping inside the sequence. Okay, so you can drag and drop inside the sequence only. Okay, that take care of all the data flow. Now you can see here property pan. Have a look on the property pan. So here you can configure everything. Okay, how to send the message, what type of message you can send. There are two options. Either you can send configure directly through this, or you can configure directly from here. Understood? Now one more thing I just wanted to say, I told you about debugging. There is no concept of debugging here. Okay, debugging is nothing but here the blue icon. Whenever you find a blue icon, okay, on the sequence pan, or let's say any pan here, so that indicates that there is certain kind of an error. Something is wrong here. Understood? If there are no blue pan, okay, so blue icon, it indicates that your program is correct. Got a point? Let's try to design, okay, some simple greeting message. So if you want to have greeting message, so what I will do, I'll have hello. Okay, hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Once, just I'm typing here. Hello, 8th semester students. Sorry, 6th semester students. Welcome. Welcome to UiPath. RPA using UiPath. Welcome to RPA using UiPath. Okay, UiPath. Have a look on this. So I want to display this one. Understood? Welcome to RPA using UiPath. But still, I'm getting what error, right? Can you see this? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, basics. Yes, just be patient. Next session will have more interesting projects. Okay. Have a look on this. I'm getting an blue icon here. Okay, that indicates that there is something wrong in the contents what I have given. Understood? The thing is, if you are, suppose generally what happens in machine is, suppose let's say you are displaying one in screen, okay, for our brain that one is an integer, okay, or that one is a digit for us, but when you are storing that in machines, it will store in the format of strings. Understood? The strings. Here also, in RPA also, okay, whatever you are storing, whatever you are displaying on the front screen, everything in the end, last, everything should be in the string format. Hope you are clear. Understood? So since it is a string, so if you want to display a string, always remember we can display using this double quote. Okay, strings always will be displayed using double quotes here. I think you might have experienced this in C++ also, C programming also. Okay, always we represent the string with what? Double quotes or the single quotes here. Understood? Hope you are clear. Now it should be removed. Let's see. Okay, there is something wrong here. What is that? Have a look on this. Can you see this? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Have a look
yes,
on this. Okay, so blue icon is not there now. That means my program is ready to run. Okay, there are no error here. Okay, you can save this or you can publish also. There are two options. Understood? So let me try to run. If you want to run this, just hit on this green button, run. Understood? Automatically it will be minimized. Okay, so that the complete will be minimized. Let me minimize this also. Okay, so this, let me close this one. Let me close this one also. Okay, hold on, since my system is heavily loaded, it takes little time. Okay, if you have a good system, you can. Any configured system, okay, it will be a quick process. Hold on. So now the robot is preparing now. Okay, so the robot is executing in the background, okay, to display that greeting message. Hold on. Yeah, you can see here. Can you see this, participants? Hello.
Yeah.
Have a look on this. It got popped up. Trust me, after pressing that button run, I have not done anything. I have not touched my the mouse, even my keyboard also. Okay, automatically